It's Barb coming to you from my craft studio. I went shopping yesterday. I went to Dollar Tree, Michael's, Target. I did go to Joann's, but I left empty-handed. They had their, it ended up 70% off Happy Planner and Notes, which the way that read, I thought it was the entire line of Happy Planner because it didn't say just planners. It said Happy Planner, which isn't just, doesn't mean just the planner, it means the entire line. That's what they call the line. But so I brought up a bunch of stuff to the register, and they're like, oh, only this one qualifies for the coupon. They didn't scan anything. So I'm just like, they said, just forget it. I don't want any of it, and I left. I did contact them on Facebook and said they would look into it, but I've noticed a lot of people having different issues and being told different things. One was even told that the notebook didn't qualify. You know, how could that not qualify? They told her that it was only the notes accessories that qualified. And somebody else said, yeah, I was told it was only the newest 2018-19 planners. None of the other ones qualified. So they need to get their act together. I've suggested to both Michaels and Joann, now that they have the rewards barcodes, tie all your coupons to that barcode. They scan one barcode, your member barcode, and then every coupon that you have something that qualifies for gets taken care of. It takes it out of management's hands at the local stores and a clerk who maybe doesn't understand it and just enforces the company policy. It's better for customers, it's better for staff, and it's better for the company. But they probably won't do it. But anyways, we'll get to my haul. At Dollar Tree, I bought two packs of these. There's eight in a pack, and I need, my daughter just got a new student, so I probably need at least, probably gonna need another pack. I was thinking that I needed 16, but I think I need 17 now. That's right. Oh, well, I'll probably need another pack of those. Unless I have something in my stash that will work as an extra one. I'll just see what's left from last year. Maybe I have something similar. I bought these party lights for a project that I am working on. I bought these just to use. I like to use cute dish towels on my in my living room on my tables to kind of cover the tables and give them kind of a seasonal look. These ones actually, I think, would even make cute placemats, to be honest with you. Just the material they're made out of. It's all that microfiber. So it doesn't really look like a towel. But anyways, I bought two of those. I probably should have bought a couple more of those, but I'll see if I have enough. And if I'm at Dollar Tree on Saturday, it'll be a different Dollar Tree. We'll see if they have them. They may not have them by then. I found these little Christmas bows that I thought were really cute, and bow making is not my forte. I keep practicing, but I don't seem to be improving. So I bought a package of the Christmas bows. And sometimes, you know, I think it's just nice to have something pre-made. I bought some leaves. I swear that I bought a package of these already, and I cannot find them. I'm thinking I must have just looked at them and decided not to buy them. But if they turn up, I'm sure I can use two packs. I do like kitty cat, but my thought was that I might be able to modify it and make it, create something myself with it. I just kind of like the shape of the frame, so we'll see. And I bought the hat for the same reason. I debated on the witch's boots or shoes or whatever you want to call them, and I didn't buy them. And if I see that one, I might still pick that up. But I don't even know if I'll get to those this year for Halloween or not, but I bought them. At Target, I bought some of these witch's fingers. I had a few left from last year, but not enough for the class. I like to give them to the class and our neighbor kids, so those. I bought this for a project that I have in mind for my latest collab that I'm doing. So I need to get that done. And then I bought this pad of paper. These were from the wooden plaque, and this and the fingers were from Michael's. This one's the double-sided one from the Moonlit Manor. I've gotten both of the double-sided ones now. I wasn't sure I was going to buy this week, but my store had this pad left, this one, and they had one of the other line, the one that's not double-sided. I can't remember the name of that one, and I've already tore mine down, so I can't look it up. But I wanted to get the double-sided ones for sure. I'd like to get the single-sided ones that have the treatment, but I didn't want to buy two this week, so I just went with this one. At Target, I bought this mason jar set. This one was a $3 item. I'm thinking I might cut out some Halloween type things in vinyl and use these as part of a decor item I'm working on. This one was kind of bought for the same reason, a little. I needed more AAA batteries for my candles that I have. These little stencils, they were a $3 pack. They weren't in the dollar spot though, they were from the back, the part of the Hide and Eat line. Again, those are for the kids' treat bags that I'm making, and this is for a project that I'm working on. I like these ones. These ones were $3. They were a little more expensive, but I like the metallic look to them. I thought they looked a little more Halloween than the other set that they had. Anyways, that's all I've got. I'm hoping to get my video on my paper organization done in the next few days. I should have a package today of the last of my paper organizers. I tried to hit Hobby Lobby. There was one more thing I wanted to get for paper organization. The new one was supposed to be open. We're getting a second Hobby Lobby in the area. And I'm really glad of that because it's in an area we shop more often. So it'll be nice to have a hobby in that area. And they were supposed to have their soft opening this week, and they weren't open yet. The opening, we were still working at the opening, and she's got a little bit of a lamp right there. To get that out. And it had all plastic over the cover. So their grand opening is scheduled for the 1st. So hopefully, I probably won't make it back until next Wednesday, because this is Hubby's weekend to work, so we won't be out shopping there. While I go with my daughter sometimes on the weekend, it's a different town, and the only store they have over there, actual craft store, is Joanne. They do have a Dollar Tree, and we usually try to hit that. But anyways, that's all I've got to share today. I want to thank you for joining me, and I'll catch you next time.